Hello, everyone. It's wonderful to be here today. I'm going to present our work studying the rare chemical reaction using deep learning. And this is the collaborative work, includes my supervisor and colleagues from UC Berkeley. And we are interested in the chemical reaction that happened during the evolution of molecules. And this reaction are the dynamical process where the molecule transits from one metastable state to another. And these transitions are rare, but they're important in many applications. For the transition to occur, the energy of the molecule must go over the energy barrier from one local energy minimum to another local minimum. So we can simulate this transition directly using a molecular dynamical simulation. But this approach is impractical and is too computational demanding. And for example, if you want to simulate, if you want to observe the simple process like the ionization of water molecules, the direct simulation will take the numerical step of 10 to the power 18, which is beyond the capacity of many supercomputers. Despite the infeasibility of the direct simulation, studying the rare chemical reaction will give a great insights in many fields, such as studying the conformational changes and design new drugs and materials and calculating the chemical kinetics. Instead of using the direct numerical simulation, researchers have developed some other tools to study the rare transition. The key challenges lies in the high dimensionality of the configuration space. For a molecule with n atoms, the dimension is 3 times n in Cartesian coordinates. The researchers face two main difficulties. The first difficulty is that where is the reaction likely to occur? The methods like some transition path sampling, central point searching, and dimension reduction can help, but requires a loss of chemical intuition. And the second challenge is that even with some very useful mathematical tools, the high dimensionality will cause the computational burdens. Some mathematicians have developed the transition path theory. In the transition path theory, the computer function is the core in this theory. And the computer function is the solution of the backward chromatography equation, and which can be used to compute the reaction rate and characterize the transition state. And approximating the computer function means that we need to solve a very high dimensional differential equation. And also using the approximate computer function to calculate the rate or to search the transition state requires some high dimensional integration and optimization, which could be very costly in application. Recently, deep learning have been served as a promising alternative for addressing certain high dimensional problems. And for the first challenges, we might use the reinforcement learning to automatically to identify the regions where the reaction is likely to occur. And reinforcement learning the goal is to train the agent to make good decisions such that it can maximize the cumulative reward when interacting with the environment. And in recent years, we have observed some very impressive agents in playing some very complicated games, such as AlphaGo. And for the second challenge, we might use the neural network-based PD solver to solve the backward chromatography equation. And the key idea in this solver is that we can approximate the PD solution using the neural network and define the loss function that's associated with the PD solution. And the recent theory shows that the neural network approximation can overcome the curse of dimensionality. In the way that polynomial approximation cannot. If we want to have some certain level of accuracy, then the polynomial approximation will require a exponential number of the parameter as the dimension increase. But the newer level approximation can only require the polynomial numbers of the parameters with respect to the dimension. Now we developed deep learning frameworks to study the rare chemical reaction to tackle the aforementioned two challenges. And our framework contains two parts. The first part is to use the reinforcement learning to find the reaction channels. And the second part is to use the neural network-based PD solver to solve the backward chromatography equation. To be more detailed, in the first part, we aim to find the regions where the reaction likely to occur. We first want to find some configuration with high reactive probability. And such probability can be estimated by shooting multiple trajectory from such from that configuration. And the agent, the goal of agent in our reinforcement learning framework is to try to evolve the configuration gradually, such that it will reach the high reactive density region. And once we can identify such configuration with high reactive probability, we can shoot multiple trajectory from that configuration. And such configuration, such trajectories could characterize the reaction channels where the reaction likely to occur. And finally, we use the configuration on this trajectory to solve the backward chromatography equation and get the approximate computer function. Now let me demonstrate the whole process of our framework using the system of the isomerization of allyl dipeptide in vacuum. And this compressed system contains 22 atoms, and which results in the 66 dimension configuration space. And the isomerization of this system can be characterized by two torsion angles, phi and psi. And the plot below shows the potential energy projects on the two torsion angles, phi and psi. And we have two dot regions, A and B, which considered as the metastable states, and between which also has the lower energy compared to other area. And between these two metastable states, there's the transition state. And in the white plot, if we do the very long time simulation starting from the configuration close to the state A, we can see most of the configuration will stay in the stay close to the state A, and will not see any transition to the state B. Now let me present the results of the proposed method. In the first plot, we show the policy learns from the reinforcement learning, which is the vector fields that's gradually to evolve the configuration. And we can see this vector field will converge to the configuration near the transition state. And once we can identify such configuration, we can shoot multiple trajectory from this configuration, and we can see this trajectory characterize the some typical reaction channel in this system. And then in the last step, in the last figure, we can using the configuration on this trajectory to solve the 66 dimensional backward chromatography equation using the neural network, and we can define the least square loss function to identify the PDs, the neural network PD solution. And we can see the computer value between the configuration with the approximate computer value between 0 and 1 is mainly lies on the transition state, which matches the result of other reference paper. And finally, I want to end my presentation by the conclusion and the perspective. And now, in this talk, I presented a deep learning framework, which includes two parts. And first, we use the reinforcement learning to automatically identify the reaction channel. And then we use the neural network-based PD solver to solve the backward chromatography equation. And then we can use it to do the calculate the rate and identify the transition state. And in the future, we can make more efforts to in three directions. First, we can gain more chemical insight from the identified reaction channel, because the reinforcement learning will identify more than one channel. And also, we can apply our proposed method to more complicated system, and also integrate some chemical insight into the neural network architecture design, because usually the neural network training is very complicated. It's very difficult. Thank you for your attention. If you want more details, you can refer to the reference paper below and drop me an email. Thank you.